Hello everyone. Today we are going to have the last video of this chapter, acid bases and salts, because we are left with three topics: washing soda, plaster of Paris, and water of crystallization. So we'll start with washing soda. Washing soda is the chemical name of a salt, and its common name of the salt and its chemical name is sodium carbonate decahydrate. Sodium carbonate is Na2CO3 dot deca 10 hydrate water molecules. That means when any salt contains water molecules, it is present in the form of crystals. So we call it crystals of washing soda when they contain 10 molecules of water in it. So how we prepare it? It is prepared in two steps. Step one is heating of baking soda. If you remember from the previous video, we have done one question: what happens when baking soda is heated? And I told you, when baking soda is heated, another important product of industry is obtained, and that is sodium carbonate. So baking soda is NaHCO3. On heating, it gives sodium carbonate along with water. Because it is heating, water evaporates and carbon dioxide gas is produced. It is dry sodium carbonate, anhydrous forming. Okay? It is sodium hydrogen carbonate or baking soda. And in step 2, what do we do? Crystallization or recrystallization of sodium carbonate. So in that case, we say recrystallization. That is for Na2CO3 plus. How many molecules of water required to hydrate sodium carbonate or to form crystals of sodium carbonate? 10 molecules. So H2O, that will form Na2CO3.10H2O. It is the product of interest and it is commonly called washing soda. Chemical name, sodium carbonate decahydrate. What is the use of washing soda? It is used for cleaning various articles. It is used for the synthesis of borax. And very important, it is used to remove the permanent hardness of water. It is used in glass industry also. More uses are given in NCERT. Now, second or another salt is plaster of Paris. You all are very much aware about plaster of Paris because you all have seen decorations on the ceilings and pillars of the buildings. So many statues you see, they all are composed of plaster of Paris. So what is plaster of Paris? We will see today. Chemically, what is it? It is calcium sulfate hemihydrate. Calcium sulfate hemihydrate. So calcium sulfate SO4, hemi half H2O. How it is prepared? There is one more compound called gypsum, which is a hard solid substance. And if it is that hard solid substance is heated at 100 degrees Celsius or 373 Kelvin, that will evaporate some water, and powder form of calcium sulfate hemihydrate is obtained. So what is gypsum? CaSO4.2H2O. When it is heated at 373 Kelvin or 100 degrees Celsius, learn any one of these, it will form POP dot half H2O plus 1.5 molecules of water evaporate. Why? Because it is a process of heating. So what is it? It is POP. What is POP? Plaster of Paris. What are the properties of this? It is white powder. It is in the form of white powder. And gypsum. Gypsum is solid and it is hard. Right? Now this plaster of Paris is stored in moisture-proof containers. There's a reason behind. If it will be exposed to moisture, it will absorb moisture and will turn into hard gypsum. So there will be a reverse process. POP, say. Sorry. From POP to gypsum, if it is absorbed to moisture, that will absorb the required amount of water and it will form hard gypsum. That is why it is stored in moisture proof containers. Right? Now what are the uses of POP? It is used, I have already mentioned, it is used for decorating ceilings, pillars and buildings, making statues. It is also used in the preparation of cosmetics. And in medical field, doctors used to support fractured bones with the help of plaster of Paris. Last topic of your acid bases and salts is water of crystallization, WOC. Water of crystallization, WOC. It is the last activity of the chapter, I think 2.15. Please check. And water of crystallization is actually the number of fixed number of molecules which are water molecules present in the unit formula of a salt. For example, Na2CO3.10H2O. We have done it right now. It is washing soda. It has 10 molecules of water. That means for one unit formula of a salt. This is one unit formula of a salt. For the formation of this, we need 10 molecules of water. And this is called its water of crystallization. Water of crystallization of washing soda is 10 molecules of water. Similarly, we take copper sulfate, which has 5 molecules of water in its crystals and it is blue in color. When heated, right? When heated, it will lose water, 5 molecules of water will evaporate and it will leave behind white anhydrous copper sulfate. White anhydrous copper sulfate. That means, anhydrous means which does not contain water, which is dry. Now, copper sulfate crystals, these are blue crystals. They contain how much WOC? Water of crystallization is 5 molecules of water. Now, if these copper sulfate, white anhydrous copper sulfate is exposed to moisture, right? Reverse process will occur. That means copper sulfate, when exposed to moisture, it will regain water, 5 molecules, and this white copper sulfate will turn into blue copper sulfate crystals. Crystals will form. Right? So this is an activity for 2-mark question. Learn it properly. There are some other formulae which consist of water of crystallization, like if you remember FeSO4.7H2O. Where do we have done it? In chapter 1, thermal decomposition. When ferrous sulfate crystals, which are green in color, they are heated, they produce brown ferric oxide. So it has, what is the WOC of ferrous sulfate crystals? Its WOC is 7 molecules of what? Similarly, calcium sulfate 2H2. What is it? Gypsum. What is its WOC? 2 molecules of water is the WOC of calcium sulfate or gypsum. Right? This is all about. If you have any problem in any topic and you want to understand, let me know. I'll make another video and will come back again. Thank you. Subscribe my channel and keep watching videos.